Welcome to beautiful day four here in Almaty, Kazakhstan. 10 different disciplines are underway today, both on the ice and on the slopes. We'll kick off the highlights at Halyk Arena with a men's hockey matchup between Kazakhstan and Sweden. We'll then check out some women's hockey, 3,000-meter speed skating, and a curling match between Russia and Canada before heading to the slopes for women's alpine skiing. Starting off here at the beautiful Halyk Arena, where Team Kazakhstan continued their dominance in the men's hockey during this preliminary round. Heading into this matchup, Sweden has one loss under their belts. They fell to the Czech Republic 5-0 earlier in this Universiad. Kazakhstan, on the other hand, they played China earlier and they proved why they are a favorite to win. They beat China 22-0 and they would look to continue their hot streak here tonight against Sweden. Officials for this matchup come from all over the world, from the USA, Lucas Wilcox Martin, Slovakia also represented, with Vladimir Nasil, Korea. They have a referee here too, Choi Sukbe, and from Russia, Nikita Viluigin. Both teams now here line up for the ceremonial kickoff before continuing their warm-up. Take a look at Kazakhstan's starting lineup, as well as their coach. Here's Sergei Starygin, and also the coach for Sweden, Pergorin Tarnland. Taking a look now at the starting lineup for Sweden, that includes number 9, Oscar Eriksson, and number 16, Ola Dolbaum. You can take a look at him here, getting ready to start the game. Here they are, first face-off of the matchup. Kazakhstan fans ready to see some fun action, and that they would get. The first goal will go to Kirill Satisky for Kazakhstan as he dizzles his way around the defenders. Let's take another look at that one. He picks it up at center ice around the defender and just chucks it in there. That one's good for Kazakhstan, 1-0 now. And Kazakhstan wouldn't be done yet in this first period. You can see Dmitry Grints here passes it in for the goal by Yaroslav Yevdokimov. Beautiful goal there. Let's take another look at that one. They're on the power play. He gets it in right in front of the crease, and Yevdokimov just able to slide it in right past the goalie's left leg. Second period now, Kazakhstan leads 2-0 over Sweden. Konstantin Savenko, he'd add one for himself, turns around and knocks it in the very, very top corner of Sweden's goal. Let's watch this one again. Right in the top corner, right above the goalie for Sweden. Beautiful shot there for Savenko. Moving on to the third now, Anton Sagadeyev takes things into his own hands from a deep, deep shot. Slap shots past 3 different Swedish players right into the 5-hole of the goalie. To end the game off, there will be one more goal for Kazakhstan. Nikita Mikhailis sets it up for Dmitry Grints, and he nails it right into the back of the goal. Take a look here. Beautiful pass there by Mikhailis. Grints has a reason to celebrate this one. Now Kazakhstan, they will take it 5-2 over Sweden. Coaches very happy about this win. Again, they have 2 wins now at this Universiad, 1 over China, now 1 over Sweden. Both teams will continue their preliminary round as Sweden takes on China on February 2nd, Kazakhstan will play the Czech Republic on February 3rd. After this matchup, the top 6 spots of leading scorers for this entire Universiad, Kazakhstan has 5 of those 6 spots, so make sure you tune in to the rest of their tournaments. They're going to have a good round. Let's move over now to Balinshalik Arena for some women's ice hockey action. Fans gathered in the oldest arena in Almaty to watch the matchup between Japan and USA. This would be a rematch of the bronze medal game from back at the 2013 Universiad in Trentino, where USA won 3rd place. But Japan made a comeback at 2015 Universiad in Granada, where they clinched the bronze medal, so these two teams have something to prove here tonight. here in Almaty, though. This is Japan's first game, whereas the USA, they'll take to the ice now for the second time after losing to Russia 7-1 on January 29th. Both teams here will look to get up their first win at the 2017 World University Games. Take a look at the referees now. Once again, from all over the world, Finland, Russia, Canada, and Sweden all represented here in the officials. Taking a look now at Japan's coach, Masayuki Takashi. He's going to look to have a good game here. The starting lineup for Japan includes Amika Yoshida. You can see her here. She's the goaltender. Eventually, we'll have 34 shots against her today against the USA. The goalkeeper for the USA is Amber Green. She will cover net in the starting lineup here for the USA. Coach Shelley Looney looking to pick up her first win here at the 2017 Universiad here in Kazakhstan. Starting the game now, the USA take possession quickly early in the first period, and they would be the only team to score in this first. Watch here as Nicole Matthews slap shots it in, and then Leah MacArthur just kind of baseball bats it in almost right over the goalie. Take another look at it here. Bounces right over the left shoulder of Amika Yoshida. In the second period now, Kendra Myers finds that same hole right over the left shoulder of Japan's goalie. She chucks it in there, lifts it off the ground in the top corner. That would be her first of what would be two goals for Myers. Just minutes later, Japan answers back as Yukiko Kawashima shoots it in, and Aoda gets the rebound and nails it in again right over the left shoulder. That will be a pattern for today's game now. 2-1, USA leading the way. A breakaway by Kendra Myers once again. Kendra Myers actually in the penalty box for tripping just before this, comes right out on the breakaway. She gets that goal now, USA 3-1. Japan now on a two-person power play. Ayuma Sonoda, she shoots one in. Amber Green able to stop it, but not enough. Suzuka Taka gets in there at the rebound, puts it in, and now USA only leading by one heading into the last couple minutes of the third period. But there wouldn't be enough time for Japan's comeback. USA takes it 3-2 over Japan. They get their first win at the 2017 Winter Universiad. This game now will end USA's preliminary round, but Japan still has one more game against Russia on February 2nd. At the end of this one, it was the power play penalty minutes that made the difference. USA, they were in the box for 18 minutes, Japan only for 12. Japan, a power play efficiency of 12.5. You'll have a look at this in a second. That's when they scored that two-person power play goal to bring it up to 3-2 at the end of this one. Day four action isn't done yet. Stay tuned. Right after this, we're going to watch Canada and Russia go head-to-head in the curling match. Almaty Arena got into some action as well with men's curling matches between Korea and Japan, USA and Sweden, Great Britain and Norway, Kazakhstan and the Czech Republic, and of course, Russia and Canada. Canada is 1-1 going into their matchup after winning over Kazakhstan and taking a loss to Great Britain. Russia also 1-1 coming into this one. They lost to Great Britain as well before beating Japan. Both teams now looking to pick up their second win in this preliminary round. This game would go back and forth until the last second, and yes, it went into 10 ends. Here's Squires for Canada. He throws the rock down. Vigorous sweeping there. Not happy with that result. Russia now has the chance to end this end. They're going to do it with 2 points at the end of the first. 2-0, Russia. The second end was a draw. Moving forward now to the third. Here's Russia's Timofeev. Throws it. Some serious sweeping action here by the Russians. They get it in to the 8 foot. Now Canada's here, Squires once again. That rock will be good and it'll bring Canada right back up to 2 points at the end of the third. 2-2, Russia versus Canada. fourth, and now Canada looking to take that lead. Slow and steady wins the race on this one. They'll have two ready to go here as Russia sets up. They're going to have to knock both these rocks out to keep it as a draw. They knock one, but Canada's still closer. They'll pick up another point. Over to the fifth end now. Squires releases. Gonna look to knock out that stone you see right ahead. Both of them out now. Just two in there. Russia, if they can land one closer to the middle of that button, they'll pick up the point for this one, and it'll tie once again at 3-3. Russia now looking to land one in the button. But some vigorous sweeping by Canada's Krell gets that one right out of that 12-foot ring. And now it's Canada's turn to shoot one. Kind of the same situation as we had last time. There's two stones in there, one from each team. This one just needs to land closer to the button than the others, and Canada will pick up the point. As you watched here, that one is pretty close to the inside. That one's good for Canada. Now they lead by one, 4-3 at the end of six. Moving forward past the seventh, that one was a draw, so we're on to eight now as Canada releases the rock.
We find two, halfway.
This is Canada's last throw before the Russians have the last of the end. Here's Timofev. Russia really looking to catch up now in the score. That one, good for 1 point. Again, a tie game between these two teams, 4-4. Once again, no points rewarded in that ninth end, so we're moving to the last one here as Timofev releases it for Russia. Knocks out Canada's middle rock. Canada still has one up in that top right-hand corner. You can kind of see here Squires, the last throw of the game. This one could decide it, whether it goes to Russia or to Canada. Again, right now it is 4-4. Canada does it. That'll be it. They take this one 5-4 over Russia. Now Russia moves to 1-2 in the tournament. Canada, they will move to 2-1 after this 5-4 victory over Russia. This team now tired after a win. It's thirsty winning sometimes. They have USA and Japan up next. Let's head out into the mountains now to Mideau Sports Complex, where we'll see women compete in the 3,000-meter speed skating event. 32 athletes would compete today in this event, but only one would earn the gold. Let's get into the action here. First up is a race between Russia's Elena Sakaryakova and Poland's Ursula Wadarczyk. You can see Poland's athlete here. She'll be dressed in red. She'll be on the inner side. And here is Russia's in the white and blue. She'll be on the outside. Both athletes here burst out of the gate, and it's 3,000 meters from here. You can see the line there from the leader right now. Sakaryakova way ahead, 1,000 meters in. She is leading the way so far over her opponent and over the leader. Five laps to go here. She's still just under a minute and a half. A minute later now, she's all alone as Russia's Wadarczyk, she takes one on the ground. She's done now for the race. Still still leading the way over that leader. She has a big lead here as she starts to get tired. You can see the fatigue in her legs start to kick in. She gets a bit slower, but she's going to push for the finish. 4 minutes, 27.89 seconds. Up next is Korea's Jun Yang and Japan's Nana Takahashi. You can see here, here's Takahashi. She's on the outer. She'll be in the dark black. Korea's Jun Yang in the dark blue on the inside. Takahashi just behind that leader. You can see there as they approach the first mark. 1,400 meters to go. Takahashi close to that leader, just behind. Two laps now to go for this Japanese athlete as she continues her speedy race around and around and around. 4 minutes, 15 seconds. Just ahead of that leader right now. Again, see that fatigue start to finish. Makes it to the finish line with a time of 4 minutes, 27.68 seconds. That time will be good enough for the silver medal for this Japanese athlete. Last but not least, Belarus's Marina Zuyeva and Korea's Youngsoo Lim, they'll be up next racing for what will be the gold medal. Just to keep in mind here, these two athletes aren't necessarily racing against each other, but racing the clock. Here's 7 seconds into the race, both before the leader right now, doing well on their speed. If they continue this one, you will see who wins the gold medal in the end. Five laps to go here. Zuyeva, she goes out to a quick head start. You can see here, way in front of that leaderboard with just under 2 minutes into the race. 14 meters to go. Still way ahead of that leaderboard. You can see there on the bottom with the times. Zuyeva not letting up in this race. You can see her speed does not leave her. We're just over 4 minutes now as she goes to the end here. She could do it. No one else in sight. She's going to cross the finish line with a time of 4 minutes, 18.26 seconds. That one will be good enough for the gold medal for this athlete from Belarus. She will take the first place. The silver medal will go to Takahashi from Japan, and Russia's Elena Sokryakova. She will get the third place. Takahashi, this is her second medal here at the Universiads. All three of these girls, though, would get their medals directly after their event. The last event for today's highlights is women's alpine skiing over at Shymbalyk Mountain. Leading the way from yesterday's qualification round is Belarus's Maria Shakhanova, Russia's Anastasia Silenteva, and Slovakia's Barbara Kantorova. It gets as cold as -6 degrees Celsius up on the hill, so all those athletes look for different ways to warm up before their big event. From shaking to twisting, and from swinging to bending, from running to clapping, all 25 of these athletes are ready to kick it off. First up is Slovakia's Barbara Kantorova. Again, I'll remind you that she was third place in that leaderboard from the qualification round just yesterday. Now we see her going down for her final run here down Shimbolic Mountain. Kantarova quickly picking up speed here. She goes around all the markers. You can see how close she gets to these markers here. Take a look. Just over 2 minutes into this race for her now, coming to an end. You can see her score compared to the leader right now from Japan as she makes her way past the finish line. She's going to finish 0.0 seconds faster. That's 2 minutes, 10.35 seconds. Here's Asa Ando there in the middle. You can see she's knocked out from that top spot. Up next is Russia's Anastasia Silenteva. Here she goes down the mountain to start the race for her. Just to remind you, she was in second after yesterday's qualification round. You can see quickly picking up speed here as she goes over that hill. Around the markers here. So close to all of them as she kind of just nudges them on her way by. Almost at the 2 minute mark here. Nearing the end, here's Silenteva. You can see the finish line from that other angle there. She continues to pick up speed, even closing in on the end. She crosses the finish line. 2 minutes, 8.24 seconds. Unbelievable race. Silenteva, she will move into that top spot as Asa Ando moves to third and Kantarova moves down to second place. The last race we will watch here, this one's by Belarus's Maria Shkanova. Again, looking at the leaderboards from yesterday's qualification round, she was leading the way, a favorite to win this event. Watch how speedy she is in that bright orange helmet as she comes over that big hill around the markers. You can see her pick up tons of speed down this hill. Again, just under 2 minutes into the race. She's on par to medal in this event if she keeps up her speed as she comes into this final stretch now. You can see her time here in the bottom corner. Compared to the leader right now, Silenteva, she crosses that line. 2 minutes, 10.2 seconds. That will be good enough for second place. Such a great moment here. You can see the exact moment when Silenteva realizes she has won her first gold medal at a Universiad. She was awarded that medal shortly thereafter. Fans at the event had the opportunity to watch the medal ceremony, take as many pictures and videos as they want. As Silenteva gets her gold medal, Shkanova gets her silver, and Slovakia's Barbara Kantarova gets her third place bronze medal. With this, that wraps up the ladies' Alpine combined Super G skiing, but make sure you tune in to watch the giant slalom. That'll happen February 3rd.